Okay, so I am going to make a letter, like the big letters that you would put on your walls. I normally do buy them at Walmart, the wooden ones, but they end up being $2 to $3 each, and I had done that in the past for both of my daughters in their room. But today I decided I was going to try and make one out of a cardboard box. I like to usually paper mache, so I have a lot of like boxes and newspapers and stuff like that lying around. So what I'm going to do is use this box right here, and I'm going to use this as like a template. It's just a little toilet paper roll. If you have like a napkin roll, that'd probably be better because it's longer. I'm going to use two cardboard, so it's this one whole big one that I'm cutting in half to make it twice as thick. So first I want it to be this width. That's how wide I would like it to be. I think first thing I want to watch to do is write my letter, and since I'm doing one for my son, it's going to be a J. So basically that's the length and the way I want it to be. So I'm just going to start right here, and then I want to just kind of, actually let's start right here where this line is. So I'm just going to kind of go around that line so I can get like a nice little shape instead of mine, you know, my horrible handwriting, especially since I'm not really good at drawing a straight line. But this will be good enough to help me create the letter J that I want. And then I think I'm gonna do it right here. So I'm just going to connect these lines together, and right here, so then you just want to kind of edit it a little bit, like I did mess up a little bit, so let me see, I want to go right here, this high. All right. So, then luckily I have a pencil, I can just erase any mistakes that I did make. And then I'm going to cut out my letter. When I cut out my shape, I'm going to put it on top of the other side and cut it out so I have two equal pieces, and I'm going to glue them together. After they're glued, I am going to like wrap it around with newspaper just so I don't get this like edge. I don't want to have this edge on my my finished product. So it's going to be wrapped so it's covered. And then I'm going to place an image on top and Mod Podge it. And hopefully it'll be a good thickness. I know you can buy them at Michael's and Hobby Lobby made out of cardboard already. I'm not quite sure how much that is. It might be about like $1 or $2. I'm not sure. But since I have this stuff lying around, I figured I would just go ahead and make it myself at home. So I'm going to cut this out, and then I'm going to cut out another one, use this one as a template and trace it, and then cut out a second one, and then I'm going to glue them together. Okay, so I went ahead and I cut out my J's. I have two of them. I'm gluing them together so that way it'll be, you know, extra stiff, and it does feel already like it's going to be a good thickness. So once I glue these together, I just have some, you know, not really newspaper, but you know, like junk mail that you get. I'm going to cut them in strips, and usually, like whenever I do paper mache, I would dip it in the mache paste. In this case, I'm not going to, just because it takes a long time for it to dry when it comes to paper mache, and you want it to be thoroughly dry. So instead, I'm just going to use Mod Podge because it seems to be quicker. So I'm going to basically cut it in strips, and then I will apply Mod Podge on it, and then kind of like let it glue so that these will all be covered. Okay, so it's glued, it's nice and thick. Like I said, I'm going to start putting some Mod Podge on here, and I'm just going to kind of like wrap it like this, and then I'm going to glue it. So first, I'm going to apply it, the Mod Podge, and I'm going to do it on both sides. Put a little bit more. And I think that's a good layer. And then I'll go ahead and grab right here. And come around. I think I'm just going to go ahead and go all the way around and then just cut right here. And then apply a little bit to kind of close it up right here. So see, as you can see, this will be all covered up, and it is going to be, I'm going to put an image on top of it. I'm going to do a printout on the internet. My son's favorite character is Pokemon, so I found an image online which had like a whole bunch of Pokemon characters on it. I'm going to print it out, and then after I've gotten a few layers on here of the paper, the newspaper, then I'm going to Mod Podge the image. But for now, I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to finish up putting these strips on here. Happy with the way it came out. It is stiff. Actually, I need to add a little bit right here, but it's stiff. It looks good. I'm going to put a second layer just to make sure that it's going to be sealed, like these pieces are not going to unpeel or anything. So I'm going to put a second layer and make sure that I cover up this top part. But as you can see, it's going to be nice and smooth on the sides, and that's basically the whole reason for covering it up with paper. But I really like it. I mean, it is a good feel. It's heavy and sturdy. I feel like it's going to turn out really cute. And I just wanted to say also that with the materials, all you really need is a cardboard box, some, junk mail paper, and Mod Podge. And Mod Podge, I think the one I bought was this little one. I think I got it at Walmart. I think it was only like four something, like less than $5. And you can get, you know, the paper free at home. And the boxes, if you don't have any, Most stores throw them out and recycle them, so you can ask somebody before they throw them away. Just call them up and ask them if they have any boxes you can have. I know I've done in the past, gone to like Dollar General and tell them, you know, if they had any boxes that I needed at the time, you know, was to move. And they had like a whole area and they just let me grab the boxes I wanted. So you can always call stores and ask them if they have any boxes you can have. You could probably go in the back and look in their recycling bin, because if they don't have it locked, you can just take from a recycling bin. I'm sure it's no problem. Other than that, sometimes I get them at work. So if you have a job that has boxes lying around, maybe once in a while you'll see a box that they're about to throw out. Just say, hey, can I have the box or whatever? And you know, it's that easy. I like to accumulate boxes for moving purposes and for definitely paper mache, because I do a lot of paper mache. But I am really happy with the way this came out. So I can't wait and to see what the finished product's going to be once I get the image on there. But so far, so good. I really like it, and I can't wait to make more letters. Okay, so here's my letter. It's good to go, nice and dry. I printed this out and then cut it out with the X-Acto knife. I'm going to place it somewhere, probably like around here in the middle part maybe. I also printed out a few more images that I'm going to have like put all over to fill it up, so it might end up looking like this. And then like that. I also have another image that I might stick on there. I'm not sure if I'm going to or not. But like I said, I did just, you know, I want it to be Pokemon since my son loves Pokemon. I got these little ones I might stick on there. And then I've got this one right here that I thought was really cute. And I'm probably going to cut this one out with an X-Acto knife as well, but I'm not quite sure if I am or not, because I don't know if I stick it onto this pattern if it will be obvious that it's a heart. But anyway, so I just wanted to show that I'm going to use this image that I printed out, and then I cut it with an X-Acto, and I'm just going to place it on there like that. It's going to be super cute, I think. I'm not sure how much of the image is not going to be on there, which I wish, you know, most of it, hopefully most of it will, because I know that it's quite a big image, and I'm going to have to cut some of it off, so it's kind of sad. Maybe I'll put it like this. We'll see. But it's going to be super cute, so can't wait. Alright, so here's my finished product. I think it looks really, really cute. If you look really close, you can see the little characters. And then I put the heart up here. And then I went ahead and cut it and put a little bit going to the side, so it looks really cute. It's not just completely cut off. It's still there. So I thought that looks so adorable. See, there's a tail. I love it. I think he's going to love it too. I can't wait to show it to him. And it's just cute for his room. You know, he can either hang it on the wall or put it on the desk or something. Or next to all his other Pokemon things. So I think he's going to like it. I love it. I think it's adorable. And I don't know. I think I'm going to make some more letters. I'm not sure if it's going to be his name or what. But I'm definitely going to do this again. I really liked it.